This is Malaysia's GGK Commando training course, designed to separate the boys from the men and turn what's left into elite soldiers. But to earn the Green Beret, they must first survive 13 weeks of hell. A brutal selection course that almost half will fail. And only the best will survive. Before large forces hit the combat zone, Malaysia's Grup Gerak Khas commandos are the first men on the ground. Sneaking in deep behind enemy lines by air, sea, or land.
Dipecahkan kepada kumpulan-kumpulan kecil. Yang mana kumpulan-kumpulan kecil ni kalau kita tengok zaman sekarang ni lebih kepada operasi gerila.
To gather intelligence.
Maksud dia kita hanya memerlukan 5 orang anggota kita yang pakar dalam latihan-latihan ni. Dan kita akan carilah local resources daripada mana pun.
Rescue hostages or make the kill. They get in and they get out undetected. But what makes them a cut above the rest is their ability to fight and survive in some of the world's most extreme jungles. Malaysia borders 6 countries in a region plagued by past conflicts. One of which gave birth to this elite unit. 1963, neighboring country Indonesia launches the Crush Malaysia campaign, sending troops to attack the newly independent nation. A difficult border war was fought deep in the rainforests of Borneo, and a new elite force was needed, skilled in unconventional jungle warfare. Britain's Green Berets, the Royal Marine Commandos, were sent to help train a new group of fighters. 1,600 soldiers volunteered for training. 300 were selected. Of the 50 that went through the first course, only 12 passed. Today, there are fewer than 3,500 GGK Commandos, a small elite club. To join it, these men will have to go through 3 months of relentless physical and psychological torture that will break all but the best. And the pain starts here. The Special Warfare Training Center in Malacca, Southwest Malaysia. Five a.m. 180 new recruits are in week one of their course. Just to get here, they have already passed a 6-week selection process. Now, these survivors are about to start the real thing. If they thought they knew what was ahead, they were wrong. In phase one of this course, instructors are looking to lose the weakest recruits as quickly as possible. They've just begun 36 hours of continuous hell that will push everyone to the edge. It seems like torture, but it's designed to find out who really wants to be here.
I want to challenge myself how far I can go. It's called adrenaline rush.
To join the commando, you must be volunteer. So if you enter the main gate, there is a word say, if you are not sure, please go back.
The tiger is the commando's regimental crest, signifying bravery, ferocity, and strength. Qualities they expect those that pass to possess. They've done 5 hours of endless brutal exercises. The recruits are exhausted. But weakness is not accepted. Recruit 12 isn't keeping up.
kebanyakan yang susah kita ada macam didikan ketabahan. Bagi saya setakat ni saya boleh ikut lagi lah.
Go! Kopro, masuk lah tadi. Kopro, kau ngerti tak?
Go!
Pak, lewat, go! Pak! Masuklah, apa dah, Pak?
Boleh, Dap! Boleh, Dap!
Boleh,
Dap!
This is what they are fighting for. The coveted Green Beret. Inherited from the Royal Marine Commandos, it's an iconic symbol of an elite group.
Jadi, Green Beret ini, sesiapa yang memiliki Green Beret diumpamakan adalah askar yang terbaik di dalam Malaysia. No!
But only a select few of these recruits will ever get to wear it. The men are drained, but there will be no rest. They've only completed 7 hours. They've got 29 more to go. Next is an 11-kilometer run. With a 17-kilogram combat load and 87 minutes to finish it. To make it harder, it's midday, and the temperature is above 30 degrees Celsius.
This giant spotlight melting me down. It's a real tough.
In this heat, losing fluids is a real problem. Muscles start to cramp and the body starts to overheat. Dehydration means failure. 40 minutes into the run and the sun has claimed its first victim.
Dalam keadaan macam ni, dia dah kita dah banyak running basic commando, jadi dah bagi saya dah biasa.
If recruits are sent to the hospital, they automatically fail the course. With little time left, they can't afford to slow down for a minute. Time is up. 77 have failed the run. And the 30-degree heat has taken its toll on everyone.
My knee was injured. I feel okay. I can breathe normally, but I'm totally set.
24 hours in, and overnight another 7 recruits have dropped out due to injuries from yesterday's run. 173 survivors are already on their next challenge. It's the 300-meter obstacle course, designed to test balance, confidence, and above all, teamwork. The last hurdle will be the toughest, a 3.5-meter vertical wall.
They have to work in team. They cannot work solo. If they make it solo, they just cannot make it.
Teamwork is essential to be a GGK commando. In real operations, teamwork will keep them alive. Recruit 12 is once again struggling, holding up the rest of his team.
Saya dah 31, yang gegen ni baru ada yang 21, 20. So saya terpaksa bersaing dengan umur yang 10 tahun lebih bawah dengan saya.
Some teams have already reached the final hurdle, the 3.5-meter wall. Now, it's time for teamwork. To clear this obstacle, they need to form a pyramid. Short guys on the bottom, tallest and lightest aiming for the top. A falling recruit becomes the first casualty. His M16 rifle muzzle puncturing his neck. In battle, failure to work together could mean more than a flesh wound. They reorganize and clear the wall. It's 30 hours in, but not over yet. This obstacle course is just preparing them for an even tougher challenge. Tonight, they will do it in the dark, 10 meters above the ground. Making a small mistake up here could be their biggest. Recruits fighting to become a part of Malaysia's elite commando unit are in phase 1 of one of the toughest selection courses in the world, 7 of 180 have already failed, and those who have made it this far are totally exhausted. Their next challenge will be the toughest yet, the dreaded Tarzan course. It starts with a 10-meter rope climb, 8 obstacles designed to test their nerve, coordination, and teamwork. Recruits have to navigate from one end to the other using ropes and beams without falling, all at night.
It's a confidence building exercise, because that's why you can see this height and see only a small cable to cross the log, and also they have to crawl in the rope.
Yang mencabar sekali, masa last sekali untuk didikan ketabahan tu, dia ada macam Tarzan swing tu. Ada setengah yang tak dapat kejarin tu, terus jatuh ke bawah.
What would be easy for seasoned soldiers under normal circumstances is now compounded by fatigue and stress.
Siapa yang tidak gayak klik ke bawah, dia akan rasa tak boleh buat benda ni.
One recruit has paused at the top, but there is no way down.
No! No! No!
Recruit 12 is doing better than expected. But he's got one final hurdle, the Tarzan swing.
Saya rasa benda tu gembira sebab saya boleh lakukan. Sebab lagi cepat kita buat, lagi cepat kita punya benda tu selesai.
36 of the longest hours of their lives have ended. But despite tonight's success, Recruit 12 has failed week 1 of the course.
Untuk kenangan tu, saya rindu bersama dengan saya punya intik saya ni. Sebab kita makan sama, tidur pun kita sama-sama bangun, makan pun sama-sama yang ada.
144 recruits remain, and they have 56 more days of the selection course to go. Phase 2. The training from here moves into a more tactical phase. It's going to get tougher and tougher. Next up, they face a 160-kilometer non-stop forced march that will take them 3 days. It's the equivalent of doing almost 4 marathons back to back, with little food and even less rest. Normally, 1 in 4 don't reach the finish line.
Untuk menguji ketahanan mental dan fizikal. Sekiranya berlaku yang sebenar, kita akan lari lebih daripada ini lagi. Jarak dia lebih jauh lagi pada 160 km. Maybe 200 km atau lebih lagi lah.
The GGK normally operate on foot, covering huge distances. But getting behind the enemy lines sometimes requires another skill.
Kalau kita boleh jalan darat, mungkin banyak risiko yang kita akan, mungkin dengan booby trap, dengan jerangkat sama, dengan berbagai halangan. Dan masa yang diambil adalah lambat. Mungkin 2-3 jam kita nak terjun. Dan kita akan digugurkan kalau melalui static jump. Mungkin dalam 55 saat ke 1 minit, kita dah sampai ke sasaran daripada buka payung. So tujuan kita menggunakan parachute ini adalah untuk menyusup ke negara atau ke tempat musuh itu dengan lebih cepat dan selamat.
But these recruits have to learn to walk before they can fly. It's day one of the longest march of their lives. The terrain is uneven and the weather extremely hot. 50 kilometers on day one, and 9 recruits have already dropped out.
Sebab dia melampaui
akal manusia biasa. Saya daripada Kuala Lumpur, KL. KL lah, lahir KL. Besar KL. Sebab semua orang pandang orang KL ni lemah. Leput. Sangat lemah. Tapi saya rasa orang KL boleh. Orang KL boleh berjaya sebagai seorang komando.
They're losing more fluids than they can possibly replace. Dehydration is a real threat. Instructors keep a close eye out for telling signs. Its first symptoms are muscle cramps and dizziness, which can rapidly lead to a full body shutdown.
Dia gigit kayu tu supaya dia tak boleh menggigit dia punya lidah sebab dia sekarang ni keadaan panas, panas tinggi. Dia hilang dia punya kawalan otak dia dah hilang, jadi dia akan gigit lidah.
The recruits are carrying 17 kilogram packs. It's up to them to decide when to snack and replace vital fluids.
Go, go! Lojok, lojok! Lepas kira!
But the instructors set the pace.
Go, go! Wagan mangaru! Cepat! Go, go!
Hey, teruskan!
Dah sampai dah, dekat dah!
They are trying to keep the pack together to avoid any stragglers who may be tempted to hitch a ride. It's 15 hours in, and for some, the end of the road. But not everyone is struggling.
Saya suka kalau jalan laju, saya suka sangat. Mula-mula saya jalan pun saya terpeleh. Tapi kaki saya sakit ya. Tapi saya post saya punya badan saya lepas tu panas semua. Lepas tu okey ya.
My body is okay. There's no much pain here and there. So my leg is still okay. So far it's so good. I can still okay. Can still smiling.
At this stage, teamwork and leadership will be judged. Recruit 2 needs his section to keep up.
I need them to be motivated in everything they do. They just need to run for 5 seconds. So dash for 5 seconds and then we take rest. Soldier is about teamwork. So how big or small we are, we need to be together.
GGK commandos need to push themselves beyond the normal physical pain barrier. It takes extreme mental strength to keep the body moving. But in combat, that could save lives. 90 kilometers in, as high noon hits, some can't take the pain anymore. Despite Recruit 2's best efforts, one of his buddies is in serious trouble. Disorientation and confusion are signs of advanced dehydration.
Buddy, depan tu, buddy.
Pegang dah, pegang dah. Papa dah penyek.
His friends want him to finish, but his condition is getting worse.
Kita tunggu ada sebab dia ada doktor. Doktor akan beri keputusan lah sama ada dia boleh teruskan lagi ataupun tak boleh teruskan lagi.
They urgently need to rehydrate him. If he doesn't get saline solution in the next few minutes, he could go into shock and die. 135 of Malaysia's toughest men are in the middle of a 3-month selection course to become part of Malaysia's elite special forces unit, the GGK Commandos. They are in phase 2, a 160-kilometer forced march lasting 3 days. A recruit has become severely dehydrated. If he doesn't get saline solution fast, his body could shut down. He wakes but needs urgent medical attention. He'll survive. But for him and 14 others hospitalized today, it's the end of the line.
Oh,
dia tenaga kadang-kadang tak sama kan. Sebab saya minat je ni. Dia bila kita dah dulu satu peringkat kita jadi ada satu kenangan bagi kita lah. Macam peringkat ni macam saya yang gagal, saya tengok member-member yang apa ya, lulusan. Saya jadi macam sedih lah. Sebab tak boleh ikut lah.
...120 kilometers into the march and the survivors finally reach a rest stop. No one has voluntarily quit yet, but with 60 kilometers left to go, it's early days.
First, tomorrow will be much harder. It's my last instructor said that for the first 30 or 40 kilo, you will use your strength, okay, your feet, your physical. And the rest, you just use your mental to keep going.
Yang dia orang fikir sekarang ni dia mau nak pakai green berry. Itu saja dia patut fikir. Sebab itu dia punya matlamat dia datang untuk menghadiri khusus ni. Kalau dia nak fikir dia penat, dia akan gagal.
Tomorrow they are going to have to do it all over again. Face dehydration, hunger, pain, and the worst enemy of all, self-doubt. GGK commandos are sent to places where self-doubt isn't something they can afford. 1993, Somalia's capital Mogadishu is plagued by poverty and civil war. Two U.S. Black Hawk helicopters were shot down, and Malaysian special forces were called in to help with the rescue operation. Under constant attack from rebels, it took two full days to get the trapped soldiers out. One GGK commander was killed and several wounded. Real missions can rage for days on end without clear outcomes. But commandos must have complete confidence in their abilities to grapple with the unknown. 5 a.m., day three, and the recruits have begun the final day of their 160-kilometer forced march. It will take all their willpower to push to the end.
Kemampuan fizikal tu tak penting kan, yang penting kemampuan mental. Halangan pada diri sendiri tu merupakan musuh kita tu, diri sendiri.
With 10 kilometers to go, some have dug deep inside to find the energy to make a run to the finish line.
Dulu saya nak nombor satu lah. Itu yang saya sebab saya seorang, saya budak India. Saya buat latihan lah. Bukan untuk latihan saja. Bukan untuk training saja.
Oh, 160 kilometers in 3 days. Recruit 143 has completed his personal mission. He is the first to cross the green clearing that marks the end of the forced march. The second group, hot on his heels.
Sangat teruja kan, sebab macam luar jangkaan. Macam tak percaya pada kemampuan kita kan. Bila kita melaluinya, kita akan dapat bayangkan macam mana yang orang katakan kan, sangat dahsyat komando ni kan, amat digurumi, ditakuti kan.
...118 recruits have made it to stage 3 and it's about to get tougher. Their next mission, get dropped deep into the harshest place imaginable and survive for 2 weeks without food or water. When commandos need to hide, they go where their enemies will not follow them. The GGK have mastered the art of jungle warfare after successfully beating a communist insurgency in the 1960s. Rebel strongholds were deep inside Malaysia's jungles. The GGK not only had to find and fight them, but learn to survive in this most hostile of environments. Commandos would often be sent into the jungle with 1 month's supply of food for operations that could last 3 months. Exhaustion, tropical disease, and wild animals claimed the lives of some men, but the experience gained made them ultimate jungle fighters. The GGK chose the most extreme environment to train their commandos in survival. Malaysia's remote swamplands are as uninhabitable as it gets. They have nothing but a machete and three simple tasks: to find food and water, and to build a shelter. But in this environment, nothing is easy. They face extreme heat, heavy rainfall, mud, snakes, and crocodiles. And just to make things worse, mosquitoes and sandflies are everywhere. An early survival tip from the instructors makes the start slightly more bearable.
Ni kadang macam kita ada ni orang cakap agas, nyamuk je kita kalau berlumpur, kita tak boleh nak tu lah.
This exercise simulates escaping from capture and surviving a period of evading enemy patrols.
Cepat.
Kita pilih tempat yang begini, tempat payah begini sebab tujuan utama dia musuh susah nak kesan, dia susah nak bergerak masuk. Ini kita kawasan payah ni kita buat untuk dia nak menyesuaikan diri dengan keadaan tempat ni lah.
The mud sucks away whatever energy these recruits have left.
I never been in this state before. I miss my sister's cooking. Yeah, we still got much to go.
Recruits are allowed to eat anything they can catch, but they must share it.
Kami kejar dengan kawan-kawan. Rasa seronok sangat dapat biawak ni.
Mesti tak makan.
Binatang ini, walaupun saya keadaan darurat, saya mesti dapat boleh makan lah. Untuk menambahkan tenaga. You cannot choose favourites here. You just eat things. Yeah, survive.
Okay, dia pakai tungkorak tu menandakan dia telah berjaya menangkap, jadi dia akan jadi bangga. Jadi benda ni dia akan menjadi menarik minat kumpulan-kumpulan yang lain, akan berusaha lebih lagi untuk nak survivalkan diri dia untuk nak hidup.
The water in the swamp is brackish and unbearable to drink. So Malaysia's torrential rainstorms are both a source of suffering and salvation.
Dengan keadaan yang sejuk, bila menjelang malam dia akan bertambah lagi sejuk. Jadi ini pertama kali masak kera, jadi kera punya kepala disambungkan. Jadi apa yang boleh buat sini, kera ni dibelah, dibersihkan perut, lepas tu disalai. Itu je yang boleh buat. Rendam air masin, salai. Supaya dia ada rasa masin-masin sikit. Salai sampai kering. Saya kerja awam dulu, berat saya sebanyak 79. Dan sekarang ni saya rasa mungkin berat saya menjadi 69.
In their weak states, it's hard for the recruits to catch enough food. So as a backup, they are given survival tip number two.
Siput belitung ni dia boleh mendatangkan tenaga segera. Kalau dia makan dalam seekor, dua ekor, dia boleh pulihkan balik tenaga dia, tapi dalam jangka masa pendek. Dia boleh bertahan hanya untuk sekerak hari lah. Dalam 5-6 jam, macam tu.
But they are only allowed to eat 3 snails a day, forcing them into the worst possible state. Those who break this rule will face the consequences. Candidates are in the last month of a 13-week selection course to join Malaysia's elite GGK commandos. They are in their third phase of training and have been dropped deep into swampland to learn how to survive. Snails are the easiest food to catch here, giving them the energy boost they desperately need. Learning to cope with situations this bad will help save their lives in real conflict.
Jadi ini adalah siput yang diorang cari untuk makanan diorang dalam keadaan lapar. Dia ketuk menggunakan parang bagi pecah dia macam kerang dia ni. Lepas tu dia akan koyak, dia akan tarik dia punya ni. Sebab kita mesti kena potongkan bahagian ekor dia ni. Sebab baru dia boleh, sebab dia ada musi ni, isi dah. Dia melengkar-lengkar dalam ni, dia ikut ni.
The isolation is a good time for thought.
sebab dalam latihan komando ni tu keluarga memang tak bagi lah, takut risiko. Tapi saya datang sini secara sembunyi lah, tak bagi tahu dia bahawa saya nak masuk komando. Setelah saya sampai kat Melaka selama 2 minggu baru saya kontak bagi tahu dia yang saya dah ada kat Melaka. So dia tak boleh buat apa sebab saya duduk kat Melaka lah. Dia tak dapat nak halang lah, tak dapat nak suruh saya balik. Sebab utama saya masuk komando memang saya minat komando.
At 2 a.m., a group has been caught eating extra snails. Not sharing this bounty is against the rules.
Jadi tak ada makna lah kita buat latihan survival untuk diri dia.
Recruit 2 was the leader of the pack. His whole team will be punished. They will wash the mud from their bodies and be tied to a wooden platform exposed to the elements.
Dia akan merasa kesusahan, dia rasa perit, digigit oleh nyamuk, agas, dia tak boleh nak bergerak, dia tak boleh nak tampak-tampak, tak boleh. Jadi dia akan, mungkin dia akan insaf lah.
It looks sadistic, but the message will stick with them forever.
Sebab komando ni dia akan bekerja dalam kumpulan yang kecil. Mungkin 5 orang, mungkin 10 orang. Jadi dia tak ramai macam ni. Jadi bila dia tak boleh nak bekerjasama dengan kumpulan dia, jadi gagal lah. Dia seorang boleh bekerja, bermakna dia tak boleh juga nak melaksanakan tugas tanpa kawan-kawan dia.
This swamp will claim the weak, and it will take everything they have to continue. The chances of making the grade have just taken a very bad turn. The group was tied up the entire night. They've survived it, but the next day brings new challenges. Normally, these men need 2,500 calories a day. Here, many are living on less than 3. Some have lost up to 9% of their body weight. They are weak and tired, but the elements show no mercy. The threat of flooding has forced them to move their shelters to higher ground. Recruit 2 needs to push his team into building a treehouse that can withstand the harshest conditions. But his own energy levels are at their lowest point in the selection course.
So water level can be up to here. So we need to build above the water level. So at the center of the, we put Y to support at the center. After we finish this base, we'll be starting to build the roof as camouflage.
In a real situation, it's not just about survival. These men need to be alert and avoid capture. Discipline needs to continue even here. Those who don't keep to these rules are punished.
Kesalahan mereka kerana tidak menjalankan tugas dengan betul. Kita mahu 1 kilo. Dia punya makanan, tapi dia buat balik dalam 5 ekor ataupun 6 ekor. Mana kesalahan dia tu besar. Terpaksalah dia dimasukkan ke dalam penjara.
The recruits have no idea how long this torture will continue.
Komando ajar dia dapat tak macam ni. Lalu kakak yang lain tak dapat, aku dapat macam ni. Kira lain dari yang lain lah. Komando.
Ini kira untuk dia merasa macam mana sekiranya berlaku perkara macam ni, inilah dia akan rasa. Kiranya dalam peperangan sebenar, dia orang mungkin bukan macam ni lah. Mungkin dia orang akan lebih teruk lagi lah.
The recruits are released just before the high tide reaches its peak. The swamp phase is finally over. Recruits are headed back to base camp in Malacca, where they will face the moment of truth. Who made it to the final stage of the course, and who didn't?
Jadi, kepada anggota yang telah di
panggil nanti. Keluar ke hadap, bagi hadapan. Di hadapan ini termasuk 02.
On!
Untuk 05.
On!
After a month of pushing their minds and bodies to the limit, it's game over for 15 recruits. Recruit 2 was caught disobeying orders and cheating. Instructors were forced to throw him out of the course.
We commando saya sabot. Kalau tak tertangkap tak salah. Kalau tangkap pun salah. This means you're not guilty if you not get caught. So I've been caught. That's mean I'm guilty. I'll be back.
For the 103 men that remain, the course now becomes more tactical. Real soldiering skills that will turn them into commandos ready for the real world. GGK soldiers are world-renowned for their jungle warfare skills, a legacy from their beginnings in the 1960s. But modern warfare has changed. Today's GGK commandos have to respond to new global threats that bring them into an urban environment.
Before that, more toward the counter-insurgency. Now it's more toward the urban operation, or you can call it conventional warfare.
The rise of terrorism post 9/11 has required a change in tactics.
Secara tidak sedarnya, seorang anggota Gerak Khas ni kita hantar kursus tu, dia sudah ada guerrilla warfare itu punya konsep tu ada pada diri dia. Cuma dia perlu suitkan sama dengan keadaan-keadaan dia. Kalau kita cakap tentang guerrilla warfare ni dia mana-mana boleh pergi.
The recruits that make it through the selection course will go on to specialize in airborne, land or amphibious operations. They'll train in the new facilities built to equip Malaysia's commandos for the 21st century, including the Killing House.
Killing House ni lebih kepada menyelamat tebusan. Menculik, membebaskan tawanan ataupun membebaskan orang kenamaan. Macam dia nak masuk bilik, macam mana apabila dia jumpa selekor, dia nak mengambil selekor, macam mana dia tidak mahu bertembak dengan kawan dia, macam mana kita ada kontrol, kita ada control center, communication punya kontrol.
Hostage rescue requires another specialization. Snipers stationed in the outside perimeter.
So, dikawal. Sniper dikawal dan diambil untuk maklumat-maklumat terbaru dan terkini di dalam kawasan dia punya aktiviti-aktiviti musuh. So semasa tim pengempur masuk di kawasan stronghold, sniper untuk memberi perlindungan kepada tim pengempur dan membunuh dia punya teroris yang berada di kawasan koridor ataupun di kawasan sentri musuh.
A team is made up of 4 commandos. One to guide the hostage, and the others to cover them as they make their escape. Back at the selection course, the number of recruits vying for a spot on Malaysia's elite commando force has dropped from 180 to 103. Those who remain have reached the final test, known by the commandos as escape and evasion. It's a culmination of everything they have learned in the course. Their mission, to destroy a heavily guarded communication tower and escape from the enemy back to friendly camp 180 kilometers away. The enemy are experienced GGK commandos. If they catch the recruits, they will be ruthless.
Di sini kita nak uji dia. Dia faham ataupun tidak apa yang jurutih bagi kepada dia. Daripada mula hinggalah penat.
Beri perlindungan.
They will trek 10 kilometers through the jungle to reach their target. At 5 a.m., they must enter the area undetected, rig the tower with C4 explosives, destroy it, and escape through the jungle unnoticed. but the enemy are waiting in position. Recruit 14 has been chosen to lead the ambush. This is his moment to shine, as the fate of his entire team rests in his hands.
Jadi di sini Grup Komando main peranan penting sebab kita menentukan menggunakan live.
5,600. Saya berbangga dipilih dan saya orang atasan percaya pada saya nak jadi ketua untuk sebuah ini. Bapak saya betul-betul bangga dengan saya sebab dia seorang tentera. Sekarang ni yang pressure. Kuku kambing.
Final preparations before the assault. Every man needs to know his role and the action to take when they hit the enemy. Once they set the explosives, they'll use a code word, goat snails, the signal for recruits to clear the target area and make a beeline to safety. But to get there, they have a long way to go. It's 3 a.m., and the recruits have been trekking 6 hours to their target.
Saya bimbang, saya punya pergerakan ini kita ketemu musuh. Bila kita ketemu musuh, mana kan saya gagal. Kalau saya tak dapat merah hijau ni, mana hidup saya gagal. Jadi saya jadi askar biasa, tak jadi seorang daripada pasukan elit, pasukan elit Angkatan Tentera Malaysia. Lebih baik lah nak jangan tangkap dalam musuh lah tu.
Recruit 14 also has to make sure his troops stay awake. They've been on the move for hours and they're running on empty.
Masih ada tenaga untuk serangan malam ni. Semua bergantung pada tenaga yang masih ada. Baki-baki tenaga, tapi dalam keadaan terdesak ni komando dia akan mengeluarkan tenaga luar jangkaan orang kata.
Serbuan 7 orang.
Under pressure, a commando needs to be able to dig deep to stay on full alert. At 4:45 a.m., the assault team reaches their target. They prepare the attack and the explosives.
Di sini dia akan perhatikan gerak geri musuh. Okey, apa musuh akan buat? Itu yang dia perhati betul-betul adalah
ambil kedudukan.
Five a.m. strike time. They begin to approach their target.
Cuma di situ kita ada dengar sedikit bunyi lah, bunyi ranting dipatahkan. Okay, ranting dipatahkan. Hanya sedikit saja bising.
Rigging team moves in. While one team covers them, they set up the explosives. A smoke grenade heightens the confusion. Flares are a signal for help by the enemy. The recruits make their exit.
Secara keseluruhannya, saya bagi 80 ke 85% sukses.
But it's not over yet. In groups of 10, they race back into the jungle to escape from the enemy. The enemy are real GGK commandos. They will hunt down as many of the recruits as they can.
Bagaimana yang siri-siri sebelumnya memberitahu gambaran musuh memang dahsyat. Kalau ditangkap musuh memang dahsyat.
Moments later, a group of recruits have been caught. They are about to be interrogated to find out who their officer is. It's 45 minutes of excruciating pain. A brutal reminder of what they could face in the real world.
sebagai mana yang ada dalam sumpah prajurit komando dan juga sumpah kata tentera darat kan. Menyimpan rahsia negara dengan seketat-ketatnya.
Their heads are shaved as a mark of capture. They are then released to continue their escape. But as soon as they enter the jungle, they will be chased again. It may be the toughest test yet, but it will also be their most important lesson. In July 2000, Islamic militant group Al-Mauna entered two Malaysian army bases and stole weapons and ammunition. Four hostages were taken along the way. GGK commandos were deployed as part of a reconnaissance and rescue mission. During a sudden crossfire, a commando was caught by the terrorists. He was interrogated and tortured, but he refused to reveal information that might have put the rescue effort in jeopardy. His bravery saved the lives of the hostages, but cost him his own. Recruits had been on a three-month journey through hell. Of the 180 that started, 103 have reached the end of the commando selection course, including recruits 14, 143, and 51. For those left standing, it is the proudest moment of their lives.
Perasaan saya sekarang ni, saya mampu mengalihkan air mata, terlalu gembira, terlalu sedih dan terlalu seronok dan paling terharu sekali di hadapan mak ayah saya, saya mampu menyarung beret seorang komando.
Now begins their real journey as GGK commandos. They have become part of an elite team that will continue to make a mark in their country's history.